Hey, Junction City Today fans, boy, you're in for a treat because I've got Scott Jenkins, Weber County Commissioner here, just in time for Good Government Week. Is that what it is? City Government Week?
County Government Week.
County Government Week. And well, how lucky are you? Because we have one of our county commissioners right here, Scott Jenkins, and we're going to talk about what's going on in Weber County and all those other kind of things. Scott, first off, a little bit of background on you. You grew up in?
Plain City.
Plain City. Right.
Oh, yeah. Right across the street from the graveyard,
yeah,
the cemetery out there,
yeah,
and I've lived there my whole life, and ended up moving across the street to another lot that we built, and then I went around the corner to another lot, and so all the time I've lived there, I've moved about 100 feet.
You could hit you with a 9-iron
right.
shot, right?
3 times.
Plain City's changed a lot.
Plain City's changed. It's one of those little communities out there that keeps growing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, right before we came on the air, we were talking with a realtor, you and I, who was our previous guest, and she was saying, you know, give us more land, find some more land, that kind of thing, because there's a big demand to move into this area right now, and that's part of what you guys have to do as an elected official. You, and as a county commissioner, you're responsible for kind of managing where people go, what gets zoned, and those sorts of things. And are you finding that a challenge right now?
Well, so our zoning ordinances right now, they make things favorable if somebody wants to build. But what we're finding out is they believe it's not favorable enough. used to be that a half acre lot was plenty. Everybody wanted a half, and then they got to the point where they said, well, a third. And then now it's like, well, a third's still a little big. We want a quarter.
Wow.
And then now you see them going down under a quarter. They're 9,000 square feet, 8,000 square feet, these lots. Wow. And people are changing. It used to be you wanted room for a garden out back and maybe a little garage or an outbuilding, one of these little pole buildings or something like that. Well, now more and more people don't want any of that.
Yeah.
They don't want to do yard work.
They don't want to keep up the yard.
So they want a house, and the smallest yard they can have, they're happy with. Well, the size of the yard has typically been attached with the quality of the building.
Yeah.
And that's not necessarily the truth anymore. That is not the truth at all.
Wow.
And everybody worries about that.
Yeah. How do you manage all that?
Well,
I mean, because you're getting punched from both sides all the time.
We are. We have departments that manage that and deal with it. You know, it's funny, as you get into this, West Weber County. So we just had a group out there that wanted to annex into Plain City and get out of the county.
Uh-huh.
Well, that ended up falling apart. And then we had another group that wanted to incorporate the whole area into a new city.
Mm-hmm.
And I supported that incorporation. I wish that would have happened, but in the end it got voted down. So now the county, we're going to do a study on it. We're going to have to come in there and do our own zoning in a county, and that's going to end up being the front end of some kind of a city down the road, whether it incorporates into West Haven or to Plain City or to Marriott Slaterville or incorporates on their own. They'll have to make that decision. But it depends. I don't know if you remember Daryl or not Daryl. I can't remember old Christensen's name. he come to me one day when I was on the city council out there, and he says to me, he says, Scott, he says, now, today I'm a farmer, but he says, tomorrow I'm a developer.
Uh-huh.
And he says, you got to protect my rights. He says, I don't have a 401k like you guys have or a retirement.
Mm-hmm.
He says, my retirement is my land. He says, I put everything into it.
Mm-hmm.
So he says, you got to protect me there. And I've never forgot that because he's absolutely right. A farmer has 100 acres that he works his whole life on and makes a living. And when he gets 65, 70 years old and his kids don't want to farm anymore, then he's got
sell it.
Yeah, he's got a decision. He's got to sell it, or in many cases, he develops it because he can make more money developing it.
Sure, that's his income from that time,
and it's his right.
Right, and it's his land.
Right,
but on the other hand, everybody's like saying, "Don't plow up my green space. Don't put a house next to my house." You know,
You were just talking about looking out the backyard of Ben Lohman, and now you look at somebody shaving.
Yeah.
That's what happens. That's the difference.
And our theme this year for County Week is Counties Matter, right?
Right.
And there's a number of things you guys are doing to get education out there to people about why counties matter. Like, why do you have a county? Why do you have a city? I mean, we got a nation, we got a state, we got a county, we got a city, we got a neighborhood. You know, why is there counties?
Well, so a county is just one of those organizations between the state and the city, you know, where we have like-minded people that get together and they want to take care of us as a county. And it works out really good. You know, county government, we handle health and human services that cities don't handle, that comes down for the federal government. We handle lots of things like that. And so there is a place in here for counties. Now, we during this week, if a school calls us, and now this year probably won't happen, but in years past it has, they call us and we go out and talk to their classes and we explain to them what a county does, what our government looks like, health and human services. You know, right now, our health department, they're giving these vaccines out there. So you go up there to the D Event Center, they're the one running that organization right now today.
Right.
We also run services that help the impoverished. You know, we have big issues there at times. We have a lot of transients that come through, and we help that system out a lot. We have Lantern House out there that works really hard in Ogden City, and we help support that. So it's big. These issues that we handle are really big right now and complicated.
Right. Now, you mentioned the schools because you guys have an award, kind of a little contest that you've got going there, right?
We do. We have a Crystal Bowl Award that we give out based on the contributions that people make to Weber County in volunteer services. And we give those out every year. Now, I don't know if we'll give one out this year because of COVID, we haven't been as active as we've been in the past.
Right, right.
But it's a big deal.
How do you select? Can people nominate, or
nominate, and we go ahead and put these people in. And in the past, we've had some really really fun awarded people we've given that have done good things for the county.
Well, that's good. That's
it
good.
Is.
Can they nominate on your website? That's the next question. And what exactly is your website? It's the Weber County website. Let's just put it
there. Yeah, it's the Weber County website.
Here's the link right here. We're going to drop the link right in there, Scott, so people will be
able
to see that. We can take care of that. We can take care of that. It would be kind of nice if you know somebody out there that volunteers a lot in our county, if you could nominate them. Make sure that they get recognized because, you know, volunteering, It doesn't pay all that well. It's what's called volunteering.
But it's appreciated. That's why we give this award out. It's appreciated what people do.
Yeah.
And a lot of people volunteer. We have a huge volunteer contingency or group in our county, and it's appreciated.
It's incredible.
So, it is incredible. We really appreciate everybody doing it.
Well, I'm going to wrap this up, but tell me one thing people don't usually know about their commissioner. And a lot of people are going to say, what in the heck does a commissioner even do? I don't understand it. You know, they probably say, I voted for you, but I don't know exactly what you do. What does a commissioner do day to day?
Our main thing that we do, when you think about city government, if there's a bunch of property that's not in a city, it's in a county. And we are like the mayors of unincorporated.
Okay.
You're
the mayors of uncities.
Right, of uncities. That's exactly right.
Yeah.
And so we have services that we provide to the whole county, including all the cities.
Yeah.
And we have services that we provide just to unincorporated people.
Right.
So when you see a plow truck go down the road, and it says Weber County on it, you know that we're plowing snow in unincorporated cities.
You cover their fire.
Right.
And you manage their zoning or lack of zoning or whatever.
I'll tell you what else we do. When you go skiing up to Powder Mountain and you see a plow truck up there plowing the roads, that's Weber County's truck.
A good point.
Yeah.
Because Powder Mountain isn't a city.
Right. That's right. In the county.
Got it.
So we do that.
Got it.
And that's a tough push. You know, we have a machine up there that's as big as a boxcar on a railroad. And all it does is auger and blow snow off a road up there. There's so much snow and wind.
No kidding.
And that's one of the things we do.
There you go. All right, my guest today has been Scott Jenkins. He's Weber County Commissioner. As usual, you are watching Ogden's Channel. Untamed. Let's see. What do we call ourselves? We are Junction City Today.
I completely
messed that up. That's what it's like working with a pro here, Scott.
Yeah, that's what it's
like. But we want to have Scott back on much more often and talk about these kind of things, because I think a lot of people out there do not know what Weber County Commissioners do. And I think it's important that you do know what they do. So tune in again. We're going to have you back, Scott.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
You bet. We'll see you a little
later. You bet. Thanks, guys.
Yeah.